Welcome to 3D Printing Industry News,
brought to you by 3D Systems.
Today, 3D Printing Industry News reporting from Santa Clara, at the Inside 3D Printing Expo, interviewing Autodesk CTO Mr. Jeff Kowalski. Autodesk is a software giant that makes software for the architecture, engineering, construction, manufacturing, media, and entertainment industries to design, draft, and model buildings and other structures. Autodesk software has been used in many fields, from the New York Freedom Tower, to Tesla electric cars, and even the Avatar movie. Autodesk became best known for its flagship CAD software AutoCAD, but now develops a broad range of software for design, engineering, and entertainment, as well as a line of software for consumers, including Sketchbook, Homey Styler, and PixelR. The company started to play it big, very big, with its Infinity Computing Power project, and even makes educational versions of its software available free to qualified students and faculty through the Autodesk education community. Autodesk is one of the most powerful and innovative companies that joined the 3D printing industry, with special expertise not just on simple printing, but mainly on the 3D world. With one of the biggest existing users based in know-how about the 3D industry in general, with solid and wide 3D creators and experts community worldwide. What started as a small technical documentation company, becoming, not slowly and very surely, a leader in the manufacturing itself, in the most sophisticated creative world, the 3D and virtual reality. Even we, the video service providers for 3D printing industry news, owe a lot of our success to Autodesk, thanks to its amazing Maya and 3D Max software. So, let's get a few words with the guru itself, Autodesk CTO Mr. Jeff Kowalski.
Hello everyone, we're here at Inside 3D Printing Santa Clara. I'm here with Jeff Kowalski. Did I get that right?
Yes, you did. Perfect.
The CTO of Autodesk. And you recently unveiled the Autodesk Spark 3D printer to the world. Can you tell us a little bit how has that been received?
Yeah. So I should clarify a couple of things. There's a term Spark that we're using to describe a 3D printing platform that we've announced that we're delivering out to the world to enable confidence in printing, going from that 3D model to the actual final output. We've noticed that there's a lot of disruption that's happening in the market, new players entering, and we see that a lot of 3D printers that are being introduced have to come with software, and they've got to build things from the ground up into their product. It's often quite laborious for them to develop the software to drive their hardware. So we're providing a free open software platform that we call Spark to give everybody that advantage of having great experience, great user experience, confidence in what they print, high quality output for all of those manufacturers. Now, as part of introducing that Spark platform and encouraging hardware partners to come on, we're introducing as well a reference platform that we call Ember. So it's a 3D printer, it's a SLA 3D printer. It runs the Spark platform and it's meant to actually demonstrate what the Spark software platform can do. So both of those things I talked about this morning in the keynote.
That was a very good keynote, by the way.
Thank you very much.
So what's the most important or exciting thing about the Spark?
I think what's important to us is that at Autodesk, we're really trying to change the way that things are made. If you look at the tools that we've announced to create things like Fusion, our traditional tools like Inventor, all the consumer products that we've put out for people to really explore creative expression and build everything from things you might want to have at home all the way up to manufactured parts that are meant to fly in aircraft or be driven in the car. We're creating those tools that enable people to make advanced parts. And what we're excited about is now connecting that to the process of 3D printing, a new mode of manufacturing. And we're excited to put that Spark platform out there to help everybody get on board with creating machines, creating materials, and extending the capabilities of 3D printing and additive manufacturing.
Well, that's very interesting. So what do you think the future holds for the 3D printing ecosystem, and how does Autodesk fit into that?
Right. Well, I think we're still in the earliest phases, believe it or not, of 3D printing. It's certainly got a lot of attention because, you know, it's got this promise of being able to physically instantiate all these things that we could imagine. That's what's creating so much excitement about it. But I think the future is even brighter. So we're still at the very earliest phases. We're talking about a lot of things. I think the better things are yet to come. I'm looking forward to the day when we've got really reliable parts and the majority of things around us aren't heated or beaten or treated in a forge, but are actually produced using a sustainable 3D printing process that really enables us to produce really unique things.
That's very interesting. Thank you very much for taking the time, and I wish you a great show.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching 3D Printing Industry News TV, brought to you by 3D Systems.